name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Welcome. Good afternoon, all, on this, as we celebrate this Mass, the most holy body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, Corpus Christi, as this celebration is known. It's the final solemnity that we will have for a while on our Sunday Masses. I do want to, as we begin Mass, I do want to make an announcement and to call to attention, not only to you, but also to our folks who are watching on the podcast, that currently our office is under quarantine. That is to say that a group of priests met during the week in good standing, and one of them was diagnosed with COVID. So that meant the priest at that, who attended that priest meeting, were, it was necessary for them to isolate. So currently, my associate is isolating, and therefore the office and the rectory are quarantined. I have been on vacation, so I drove into Hutch today, and happily. But I want to mention, I'm very hopeful that our office will be open this week, and that we will have daily Masses this week, and that we will have adoration once more. So stay tuned. Please check our website for the daily Mass and for the office being open. And it's in the bulletin, I refer to the small article that's on page 2. My brothers and sisters, we prepare ourselves. We ask forgiveness for our sins and also our brothers and sisters to pardon us. Very good.
O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction, and to find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, the place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Strengthen the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat he fills you. Sends forth his command to the earth, swiftly runs his word.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done this for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body. For we all partake of the one loaf, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now have the sequence. Laud, O Zion, your salvation. Laud with hymns of exultation. Christ your King and Shepherd true. Bring him all the praise you know. He is more than you bestow. Never can you reach his due. Special theme for glad thanksgiving is the quickening and the living. Bread today before you set, from his hand of old partaken, as we know by faith unshaken, where the 12 at supper met, full and clear ring out your chanting, joy nor sweetest grace be wanting. From your heart, let praises burst. For today, the feast is holden, when the institution olden. Of that supper was rehearsed, hear the new laws, new oblation, by the king's revelation. In the form of ancient fire, now the new, the old effaces. Truth away the shadows chases. Light dispels the gloom of night. What he did at supper seated, Christ ordained to be repeated. His memorial never ceased, and his rule for guidance taking. Bread and wine we hollow, making thus our sacrifice of peace. This the truth each Christian learns. Bread into his flesh he turns. That to his precious blood the wine, sight as falled, nor thought conceives, but a dauntless faith believes. Resting on a power divine, here beneath these signs are hidden, priceless things to sense forbidden. Signs, not things, were all we see. Blood is poured and flesh is broken, yet in either wondrous token, Christ entire we know to be. Whoso of this food partakes does not rend the Lord nor breaks. Christ is whole to all that taste. Thousands are as one receivers, one as thousands of believers. Eats of him who cannot waste, bad and good the feast are sharing, of the divers dooms preparing, endless death or endless life, life to these, to those damnation, to see how like participation is like issues rife. When the sacrament is broken, doubt not but believe 'tis spoken, that each served outward token doth the very whole contain, not the precious gift divides, breaking but the sign betides. Jesus still the same abides, still unbroken does remain. Lo, the angels, food is given to the pilgrim who has striven. See the child's bread from heaven, which on dogs may not be spent. Truth the ancient types fulfilling, Isaac bound, a victim willing. Paschal lamb, its lifeblood spilling, manna to the Father sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesu, of your love befriend us. You refresh us, you defend us, your eternal goodness send us. In the land of life to see, you all things can and know, who on earth such food bestow. Grant us with your saints, though lowest, where the heavenly feast you show, fellow heirs and guests to be. Amen. Alleluia.
Came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day.
For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Page one and page two. Page one, we have the sequence today, and sequences are a poem. Sometimes they are set to a meter and to a hymn, a melody, and we have that five times a year. We have it at Easter, at Pentecost, at Corpus Christi, at All Souls Day, curiously, and then at Easter we have these poems. With our not having missalettes here, it makes it somewhat difficult to appreciate it.
Good. I'm going to leave the pulpit first time since I have to keep within camera range here, so I'm going to stray up here within the social distancing marks. Today we celebrate the most holy body and blood of Jesus. And yes, it does several things for us, as it emphasizes several aspects of our faith. Maybe a good way to think about it is to think about body, God's body and our body. Today we celebrate the body, the blood, the soul, the divinity of Christ. So we have Jesus' divine body and soul. We have our body and soul. Now, the divine, think of it this way. God's body and soul is meant to heal and to remake our soul and body. In this world, God's body and soul heals our soul. It, if you will, renews our soul. And in the end, in the final day, God's body and soul will give us glorified bodies. In the end, our bodies will be remade. The focus is very much on body, but also unity. We become one in the body of Christ, in God's body. Now, this quest for unity is not something that's easy. If we think about, if we think a little bit about what we are faced with here on earth, there is a need for us to come together, to unite, and to be together. And we've really realized this in the past few months with the social distance ordinance that has been put upon us. For some people, it's been very, very difficult for them to be distant from everyone. And according to God's plan, God means us to be close together, especially there are certain relationships that are meant to be very close, that of mother and child. By nature's design, that is called to be very close. By husband and wife in matrimony, that's by its very nature called to be very close. And yet, nature is fallen. And yet, we can see that nature is a cruel taskmaster. I don't want to say cruel mistress. We think of Mother Nature, but Mother Nature can be cruel. It's unforgiving. We ask that of the hundred thousand or so families of the people who have died on ventilators in the past month. Nature shows no mercy. It takes the weak, it takes the vulnerable, it takes the strong, it takes those who are ready, it takes those who are not ready. If we look about this unity of bodies by nature that we're supposed to have, it was occurring to me that even mother and child sometimes are affected in a very negative way. A circumstance that some of you may be familiar with, something called an Rh factor. Rh factor is when the blood of the child is Rh positive and the blood of the mother is Rh negative. And because of the mother not having some type of a protein, an RH protein, it makes it a very, very dangerous, can make it a very, very dangerous pregnancy. I mean, even that close relationship of mother and child is sometimes occasionally fraught with danger. And we also see among husband and wife and so many others the real danger of communicable diseases. Perhaps now more than ever, we're very much aware of that. And yet today we celebrate the unity that the body and blood of Jesus brings to us. Our second reading was from 1 Corinthians chapter 10. And Paul speaks about, because of the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we are all partakers of the one loaf. He's speaking of the consecrated bread that is part of the holy sacrifice of the Mass. We are made one by partaking in this Eucharistic bread. This is something that is of great mystery, and today, more than ever, we celebrate it. We celebrate the importance of the Blessed Sacrament and its prominence within our faith. In many parts of the world, the Blessed Sacrament is paraded through the streets. It's being publicly known. And I think our Lord has taught us in the past few months of the importance of receiving the Eucharist. I think all of us know that, having been prohibited for a number of weeks and months from receiving it, it made it very much more special when we were able to receive the Eucharist once more. This body and blood of Jesus heals our soul. This body and blood of Jesus promises to heal our bodies. And throughout the history, we've had a number of very beautiful hymns, songs, sequences, like this poem. This comes to us from the Middle Ages, Laudes Iam, attributed to St. Thomas Aquinas. But we've also had another very beautiful hymns. And one of the beautiful hymns that you may not know, that you actually know, is something called O Sacrum Convivium, O Sacrum Convivium, O Sacred Banquet is what it's called. And in this hymn of O Sacred Banquet, it speaks about et future gloria nobis pignus datur. Nobis pignus datur, what does that mean? Nobis, to us, pignus, a pledge, upon, given to us, that the Eucharist is a pledge that is given to us of future glory. It's a promise made by Jesus. And as we adore the Blessed Sacrament in the monstrance, we are, if you will, inviting God's grace into our lives. And we're reminded that His body given over for us is part of His promise. The world is a cruel place, but God is merciful. Nature is fallen. We are fallen. And yet God's response is that His Son redeem us through His body and blood by this remarkable sacrifice that He has made for us. And we don't do it very often. Not often enough. I hope that we might. When we have benediction. Those of you who remember 40 hours, 40 hours was a practice where you had a preacher, you had adoration of the Blessed Sacrament for a number of hours. It was over a period of 40 hours or so, once a year, and the local priests came together. There was almost a preached, and I'm not going to say retreat, but it was 40 hours. And the benediction was given, and there is a response. You have given us bread from heaven, having in it all sweetness. See, that may sound familiar. That's from the sacred banquet, O Sacrum Convivium. And it reminds us, even as we are adoring the Eucharist, the Blessed Sacrament, and as we are experiencing this benediction, that we are thinking ahead to the future pledge that Jesus' body and blood has given us. I pray that we continue on with the adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. As I said, I am hopeful that very soon that we will be able to have adoration of Blessed Sacrament within the church, Lord willing, within a few days yet, that we might begin the practice. And I pray that we continue to realize the importance and the centrality of Jesus in his body and blood in the Blessed Sacrament in our parish life, but also in this future pledge that he has given us. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we are gathered as one people. Let us profess one faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God.
Lord from God.
God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, let us bring the needs of our community before our Lord, trusting he will answer us.
For Pope Francis, our bishop, priests, and all who serve the church, may the Lord strengthen them in their mission of bringing the light of Christ to a weary world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our civic leaders and all who help formulate public policy, and may the Holy Spirit guide them in all that they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people in war-torn countries, may God bring them peace and security. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this gathered assembly, may the love and truth that God has poured into our hearts sustain us in all that we do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have completed their pilgrimage on earth, may they find eternal joy in their heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for the protection and well-being of our families during these times. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O Lord Jesus, pour out your blessings upon us. Grant these our needs, you who live forever and ever. Amen. We may be seated.
All in you.
lives in each of us that call the world to be. Friendships falter and crumble. Give us the courage to forgive, that we may live in peace.
Sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery, in the offerings we here present, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper, with his apostles establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the hosts of angels cry out without end, we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Benedict, our Pope Emeritus, Carl, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you, and in your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, especially for Carol Mader, for whom this Mass is celebrated, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may delight for all eternity in that share of your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Announcements are simply a reiteration of what, as I mentioned before, I'm hopeful that our office will be open very soon and that our daily masses will resume very, very soon, and also that our adoration schedule will resume very, very soon. So I look forward to that. And if all things don't go well, you'll have me next weekend. And if they do go well, you'll have a far more capable priest, perhaps. Maybe. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.